Good morning. This is Gloria Owens. We are here for gentle yoga. Today we're going to grab a chair, a mat, some blocks, and gather your props and be ready to join me on the mat for just an easy practice to open our hearts, open our energy, get grounded, and feel better in our bodies. So when we're sitting in a chair, rather than slouching back in our chair, I'm going to invite you to come towards the front edge of your chair. And depending on the height of your chair and the height of your legs, if you're petite, you actually might want to have your blocks, little landing pads for your feet, so you can really feel solid on the ground. So if your heels are in the air when you sit, go ahead and do that. So take a nice big inhale and exhale, shoulders back and down. Again, big inhale, squeezing shoulders up to ears. And exhaling shoulders back and down. One more like that. Let's squeeze some of the tension from 2021 up there and then sigh it out, let it go. Good. And then subtly on the inhale, I'm going to invite you to let the elbows swing out. And exhale, let the elbows come in towards the side body. This doesn't have to look like anything particularly. I'd like you to feel like your elbows were kind of an extension of the bellows of your lungs. Subtle breathing, and you're welcome to close your eyes if you like. Feel this from the inside out. Purposely feeling the side body, kind of like gills of a fish that could expand and contract. Starting with breath today. Good, one more like that. And this time let the arms float up with the inhale. All the way to the top. You can twinkle fingers up there. Say hi to the morning. Maybe let hands go bright, fists, and brighten fists. And then cup down through cactus pose. This is the elbows in line with shoulders. Hello, shoulder blades. Puffing out the heart here. Maybe getting a little fierce, a little spiky. This is kind of our Durga energy. The mama tiger is not going to take any BS. Yeah. And then coming on down, let those arms down. Put your angel wings on your back. Do that. Mm-hmm. We're going to do that a few times. So inhale, send this up. Exhale, cactus. Pause for a moment. And exhale all the way down. Arms float down. Again, inhaling, sun breath up, reaching, gathering, exhaling to your fierceness. And putting your angel wings on your back as your arms float down. One last time. Inhale up. Exhale, cactus. And letting those arms float down. Just put them on your lap. Close your eyes for a moment. Notice where the heartbeat is, where the breath is. It has already opened. Enlivened. And bring in hands to prayer palms in front of the heart, dropping chin towards the chest. Just having a moment to peer into your own heart today. And opening your hands like a book, little pinky fingers together. Like you could, read what chapter you're on. with so much appreciation and compassion for the chapters before. And curiosity about what's unwritten. You get to write your own story. Beautiful. Bringing hands back together. Let's interlace fingers and send those hands out in front of you. And if this doesn't feel good for your wrists, you might like let one hand take the other wrist. But it's actually good, especially for those of us on the computer, to do a little bit of stretching for the wrists and the palms here. So take that up now, but drop the shoulders. So drop the bottom of the box. I'm going to do a little tip from side to side. The seated version of holding up heaven. So really pressing up to the sky, saying hi to the side body, the waist, the love handles, the ribs, the underarms. Yep. Good. And then pausing at the top. We're gonna let those arms float down. And this time reach for the chair. So it might be the back spindles of your chair. Maybe it's the seat of the chair. But if you have a back that is supportive, that you can hang off of here, we're gonna puff our heart forward. And squeeze those wings in the back. Nice chest opener and heart opener here. So leaning into your heart this morning. What has been hanging out there? Letting there be space, letting there be compassion. Beautiful. And then releasing those arms, inhale all the way up to the top, like you could catch a beach ball here. So active, press down through sit bones, up through fingers, down through shoulders. And we're gonna take our first forward fold, so swan dive forward over these legs, coming all the way down. You can bring your hands to the floor, could be hands to blocks. If for whatever reason it doesn't feel good to have your head below your heart, you can stay a little higher with elbows on knees. Let it be a little more modest forward fold. But really see what you could let go of here. Looking through the space under your chair, really let that head dangle. Yeah. And you might even like to explore holding onto the front legs of your chair with your hands and give yourself a little pull, a little invitation for the upper back to let go a little more. Broadening between the shoulder blades. Yeah, good. And then releasing those hands, slide them up the legs, slowly uncurl through a cat back, like a roll top desk. Coming all the way up, beautiful. Spreading feet a little wider now, and you may still even want to scooch a little more, even more towards the front of your chair. A little sit bones at the edge of the chair, feet flat on the floor, knees out wider than hips, approximately 45 degree angle like that. So we're going to add a little twist now. Take a peek over one shoulder and let the other shoulder come towards the center as we spin. Yes, inhale through the center, exhale other way. And go side to side here again, consciously, mindfully, your practice. Maybe you want to move with each breath. Maybe you want to hang out on a side for a full round of breath or two. You're getting between the ribs, behind the shoulder. Starting to wring out tension here. There's nowhere to get to. Just exploring. Yes. One last round. And when you're ready, coming back to center, you can walk those feet in. They're more like hip distance apart. Let's do some cats and cows here. So cow pose is puffing out the heart, head up. Belly expands, exhale, tucking chin, pulling belly button back, rounding your mid-back towards the back of the chair. So go back and forth here. Again, cats and cows, sometimes we do these on hands and knees on the mat. But this is a great way to do them in a chair. Just to say hi to your spine, see what's going on today. Yes, timing your movement with your breath. How that feels, maybe undulating a little more. So start to let this be a little more organic. Maybe it's like you're in a wave. Yes. Again, no right or wrong. This is your practice. What would feel really delicious right now? Good. And eventually coming up to stillness, pause, letting all of that motion come to stillness, maybe with the eyes closed. Good. Noticing where we've moved. But still longing for some release. And opening your eyes. So we're going to do just a few more chair things here. I'm already taking off a layer. A few more chair things here before we get up on our mat. So we're going to do a little hip opening. So take your right foot, cross it over your left knee. We're going to use our hands to pick up this foot and knee and do a little rocking here. Yeah, so rocking the baby. Having a lot of compassion for this leg, maybe blowing your right big toe a kiss. Funny, I had a friend here in South Carolina who recently had her first baby. He's only 2 weeks old, 3 weeks old, already, you know, has his toes in his mouth. I'm thinking, yeah, it's been a while since we could do that, but we can still blow a kiss to our toes. Good. Notice you're also getting a little butt massage. And remember, you can keep this further away if you've got any knee or hip issues. You can really kind of hug this in closer if you want a little more stretch for this outer thigh. Good. So now placing ankle on the other leg, foot flexed, that protects this outer knee. Nice big inhale, sitting up. Exhale, a little leading with the heart. So we're not even rounding, we're just hinging forward. Might just be an inch or two. This is half fire log pose. Now dive the head towards your calf. Again, it doesn't have to get there. We're just going that direction. Breathing in the lower body. Nowhere to get to. If there's pain, back off of it. If there's simply sensation or, you know, the edge of the stretch, be willing to breathe around it. Good, coming back up, nice and slow, take your time. And we're gonna fold this knee up now, just hold it in. Use your abdominals to help as well as your hands. Puffing out the heart, pressing down through sits bones, up through crown of head. Could you leave left hand on this calf and take right arm out? Left arm out, let your abs do the work. Yes. And then coming on down, shake it out for a moment. Oh. Close your eyes, notice the difference between left and right legs, left and right hips. Yeah. We can't leave it like that. We gotta even it out. So, left ankle over right. I'm gonna pick up the foot and the knee and do a little rocking here. Yes. Again, you can have the foot further away, knee further away for a little less have a stretch for this outer thigh or torque on the knee. You can, you know, really hug this in like a baby if that feels good for you to create more stretch for this whole piriformis, buttocks area. Getting that little butt massage as well. Blow a kiss to your left toe. Love you, love too. Thank you. Thank you for bringing us into this new year. Good. Breathe in. A little hip opening here. Again, if you've been sitting a lot, this can help to get us a little more juicy in the lower body. So, put ankle right over the other leg, flexing this foot to protect the other knee. Nice big inhale, pressing down through sits bones, up through crown. And exhale, hinge. Leading with the heart, so we're not rounding, just a little flat back forward. Hello, outer hip thigh. So again, being kind. Nowhere to get to. And now, diving in, let the head drape, let the back round. Fire log pose. Breathing. No need to force. In fact, could you back off of it a little bit and soften into it with the exhale? Good. One more breath here. And then slowly uncurling. Oh, taking your time coming on up. Turning this knee towards the ceiling, hugging it in with the shin, hands on the shin, but use your abdominals here as well. Keeping right hand on the leg. Take left hand out. Both hands out, using your abs. Yes. And then coming back in, release it and shake those guys out. All right, we're gonna come off our chair, but we're gonna keep the chair for a moment to use it for a couple of standing poses. So I'm gonna invite you to turn your chair around if it's got a back, so that the seat is towards you. So we're gonna do downward dog on a chair. And by the way, if you wanna do downward dog on the ottoman or downward dog on the edge of the couch or the bed, wherever you are, these are all fine options too. This is a great way to get the benefits of downward dog, full back stretch without a lot of the pressure on the hands and wrists. I know as we get older, sometimes, you know, wrists and hands don't like all of that pressure. So stand in a couple of feet back from your chair or whatever you're going to use for your support, hip distance apart. And roots down through the soles of the feet, through the foundation of your building into the earth. Maybe soften the knees a little bit. Feel your dragon tail. You still had a dragon tail on the end of that tailbone. Good. Now inhale up. Touch your beach ball. Drop shoulders into shoulder blades. Pause here, mountain pose. Get plugged in. So it's a deceivingly simple pose, but the longer we hang out here, the more it's about energy. So really feeling yourself plugged into the earth, steadiness of a mountain, energy rising up through the crown of the head. You might even start to feel some heat between the palms, kind of energy ball up there. Good, now we're gonna swan dive and put our palms on the seat. Might be front of the seat, might just be the good center of the seat, and let the head come in line with the upper arms. You might need to adjust your legs. You might want to walk backward a little bit or forward a little bit. Basically, we want feet hip distance apart, tail going backward, a little bit soft in the knees, a space where we can lengthen the torso. So really feel the space under the armpits, between the ribs, head and tail going opposite directions. Breathing here. By keeping the knees a little soft, we protect the hamstrings, but we're still getting a nice back body stretch there for hamstrings, low back. How much could you melt the heart here? And then exhale. Yes. Very nice. And then walking towards your chair. Aww. Walking yourself up. Let's take a big sun breath up. prayer palms this time. Exhale over the high bar. Upward salute. Inhale up to center and exhale prayer palms right in front of the heart. Dropping chin towards the chest. Again, pausing, noticing. What has opened, lengthened, strengthened? Coming back home to your inner world. I know around the holidays, we can get so pulled out in a lot of directions. So opportunity to come back to yourself. A remembering. Good. And releasing. Excellent. So I'm going to invite you now to put your chair to the side. Put that away. Take a slurp of my smoothie while you're doing that. All right. And come to your mat. And if you've got yoga blocks, they can be helpful. I invite you to just put them up front so you have them close. And if you have creaky knees, I know I do, you might also want a little towel or blanket down across your mat, eventually as a knee pad. Or sometimes if you have a little extra bit of mat or double up your mat, a little extra knee pad. So we're going to stand in front of that right now. In fact, let's walk up towards the front of the mat. So, drop toes to heels. Toes to heels a few times. So, might even want to add a little sound here. I know we can't all hear each other in this format, but I'm hearing you all energetically, a little ha. Okay, why do you want to let go? Yes, here. Just letting yourself be here. This is also really good for the lymphs. You get to start to move some lymph and drop in. Good. So now that you've got your feet on the earth, inhale, sun breath up. Exhale, cactus. Now we got our standing cactus from more of saguaro here. Tuck your tail under, zip up imaginary jeans, micro bend in the knees. Yes. Now take a swan dive forward all the way down over these legs. Ah. And again, you can have hands on knees to stay a little higher. Could be hands on blocks. Could be hands on feet or toes. Pause in your full forward fold today. Good. Now pressing into those feet, uncurling through that cat back. So we're rolling it up. You're like a fiddlehead fern, uncurling. Head is last. Yes. And exhale, back and down. Oh, awesome. So take a sun breath up now. We're going to drop right hand behind our back. And let our left hand take right elbow. Take a tip to the left, press hips to the right. A little more opening for shoulders, for ribs. Our breath is so key, especially in this time where we've had to wear masks and, you know, kind of scared to breathe, to create space for breath, for life. So important. Good. Inhaling up. Let those arms float down, maybe feeling the difference between left and right. Yeah. And left arm up. Drop it behind your back. And we're going to let right hand take the left elbow. Hips press left as we tip to the right. And the head is just framed by the arms. It just stays in relationship as part of the arc here. So it doesn't have to drop or turn or do anything weird. Yes. Keeping that top elbow back, opening the lungs on the left side, opening the heart. Inhaling up. Exhale, swan dive forward, all the way down. Again, your variation here. Maybe you'd like to do a little subtle swish from side to side. head, the hips, and the arms. Invite that lower back to release. Oh, good. And then pausing in the middle. Inhale, uncurl. We're sliding the hands up the legs. Unfurling. Head and arms are heavy till the end. And exhale, shoulders back and down. Oh. Let's do one hand to belly, one hand to heart, and close your eyes. I'll occasionally ask you to do this to just to check in. Because our yoga is not just the poses, it's everything. Our whole thread of awareness between the actual asanas or techniques. It starts to teach us how to be more aware. Good. And then releasing. Nice job. So we've done pretty subtle movements so far. We're going to do a little more energetic movement now with breath. And this is called Breath of Joy. It's one of my favorites for really opening the lungs, bringing a lot of oxygen in. If you feel heady at all, like, woo, too much oxygen at once, just slow it down or do a more modest version. But it looks like this. It's really simple. It's a three-part inhale. So it's an inhale, zombie arms to the front. Inhale, big T to the side. Inhale, even more to the top. And an exhale, a swing. So we're bending knees and swinging right back up to our first position there. So that swing is just a nice curling and unfurling. Again, if your back feels like it wants to do kind of a more modest cat back and rolling up, fine. If you're feeling really exuberant, you want it to be, you know, like a whoo, like a big swing, go for it. Again, totally up to you what you want that exhale to be. So, inhale forward. Inhale side. Inhale top. Exhale swing. Inhale forward. Inhale side. Inhale top and exhale, let it go. Swing it forward, side, top, and keep it going. Forward, side, top. Again, your practice, don't matter if it gets it just right. Let it be really joyful, exuberant, like you are conducting the Philharmonic. Maybe something Beethoven. Yes. Good. And then inhale up, catch all that energy. Feel that energy ball, that beach ball, mountain pose get plugged in. Let all that movement stabilize. And down through cactus. Wings on the back, open heart. And back down with the arms. One hand to belly, one hand to heart. Noticing where heartbeat is, where breath is. Prana, the life force energy moving through you. Maybe sending it to some place that needs it. Some place that needs a little extra TLC or healing. Yeah, beautiful. Okay, so hands on hips. Bending knees. So this time we're pretending we're sitting in the chair. We don't have the chair behind us, but it is chair pose. So we're bending knees, knees right over feet. There's a point where either knees or ankles kind of go, all right, that's it. So at that point, send buttocks backward, heart forward. More, send hands backward. Like we are on the starting block of the swim meet, about to jump in the pool. Yes. Inhale, arms up, catch your beach ball, that energy ball, drop knees, send buttocks back, heart forward, torso and arms all in one line. This is chair pose. Yes, a little energetic, sometimes called lightning bolt. It's like, just came down to earth like that. Good. Inhaling up, exhale, arms down. Let's swan dive all the way forward now. Down over these legs. pausing. And take right foot back. Now, big step back. High runner's lunge. You can bring that back knee down and make it a low runner's lunge. So this is where I like to have cushioning for that knee. I'm gonna do this sideways, you guys can see it. So we want knee right over ankle on this front foot. If you're way out with knee forward, back this up and walk this foot forward. So you've got 90 degree shin, keeps that front knee safe. Cushioning for that back knee if you need it. We're in a low lunge here. Hello, groin. Hello, hips. Nice big inhale. Good place for blocks if you want to use blocks under your hands here. Exhale. I'm going to take a hamstring stretch by lengthening left leg and diving head towards knee. And go back and forth between these two shapes. On the inhale, a low lunge. And on the exhale, this hamstring stretch. Even though you can have your hands just on the mat, walks are really nice here. This gives you a little extra support to be a little higher. Ideally, your hands stay in the same place even as you move between these two different shapes. Good. Next time you're forward in this low lunge, leave right hand on the block or on the floor. If you have a block, you might just want to turn it to the low setting so it's kind of like a platform for your hand. Left hand on your thigh, and we're going to take a spin to look over left shoulder. Lunge with a twist. You can stay right here with hand on thigh or extend this left hand. Feel the verticality of your arms. It's reaching from earth to sky, spinning around the spit of your torso. Yes, coming on down. Let's bring left knee back and fold to puppy or child pose. So buttocks going backwards, head towards the mat. The hands can reach forward, they could be flat on the mat, they could be forearms on blocks. And again, your choice as to how deep a fold you want. If your knees or your hips want to stay higher, leave buttocks in the air, head towards the mat. And if it feels good for you to go a little deeper, buttocks towards heels, head to the mat, child's pose. Folding in, feeling the difference between left and right sides. Breathing out the back body. Our lungs are actually bigger in the back side of our body than in the front. We don't tend to think of it that way, but anatomically they are. It's a lot more space to breathe back there. Good, and then come and up on all fours. We're gonna take right foot forward for this low lunge on the other side. And if you prefer to do a high lunge, you can tuck that back toe under for a little more challenge and come off the back knee. But if low lunge is good, you can flatten out that back foot or keep it tucked. So again, your choice on what that back foot's gonna do. Might be hands on blocks, could be little teepee fingers on mat. Check out the trajectory of this forward knee. We don't want it way out over the toe. We really want to walk this front foot forward so you get a 90 degree shin when you're at the apex of your stretch there. Good. So puffing out the heart. Nice big inhale. Exhale. Sending tail back, lengthening right leg. Diving head towards knee. The right toes might peel off the mat. It's fine. And go back and forth here a few times between this lunge and this hamstring stretch. You can smooth this out. Time to really feel the transitions, to feel the edges, to notice maybe what might be tight, what wants to release. And when we do this kind of thing gently without force, the body starts to go, oh, okay, I get it. I see where we're going. I know I'm safe. And that's where we can start to let go, surrender more into a stretch. Last one. Good. And then bringing this right knee back. Let's spread knees wider this time and come down once again into your puppy or child. So puppy's buttocks in the air, head towards the mat. Hands reaching all the way out at shoulder distance or wider to the front. And child's pose is buttocks closer to heels, maybe really letting there be space for the torso and the belly here between the thighs as we have wider knees and deepening into the stretch for the legs and the low back and the hips. One more exhale here. And then coming back up to all fours. Very good. So we are going to slide out on our bellies. And if you've had something for your knees, you may want to just put it to the side so it's not under your belly. We're just going to come down all the way flat on our bellies. And stack your hands to make a little pillow for your forehead. And wiggling thighs, hips, belly, heart into the earth. And for a moment, just breathing here, noticing. You know, we don't spend a lot of time belly down unless we're sunbathing maybe, but for the most part, this is not our relationship with the earth. It's so interesting to breathe this way, to notice. And even in the midst of winter, when the earth might feel dormant, cold, covered with snow, feeling her aliveness, her heat from way down within that could come up into you, nurture you, support you. Excellent. And then walking elbows under your shoulders. We really want them directly under your shoulders, like little L brackets here. If they're too wide, you're gonna collapse. It'll not feel good for your shoulders. If it's too far back, they won't feel supportive. But really find where upper arms are 90 degrees. Thanks, pose. And this is a supported back bend, kind of like cobra, but we've got the support here. And if for any reason your low back is a little tweaky, let your head and chest come just a little lower. Get longer rather than higher. And I invite you to feel like you could claw your mat, your big cat. Move your belly button forward, your heart forward. Your head's an extension of the spine. With all the equanimity, with the eons that this Sphinx has watched. Much bigger perspective on that story, on the book that we opened earlier. Good. And now press into those hands, wing out the elbows. We're gonna come all the way down. Maybe turn the head to one side. Let's pick up the heels by bending the knees and windshield wiper the feet side to side to release the low back. Nice and easy. Or if you like to do European windshield wipers, it could be ankles crossed and then feet going out. Good. And then coming all the way down, hands under shoulders, press yourself back to all fours now. Walk the hands under shoulders, knees under hips, And take a few cats and cows now in this position. See how we have opened the spine, the torso. Butt has a little more mobility now. Hips, shoulders, neck. Yes. Excellent. And we're going to do one of my favorite twisting poses called threading the needle. It's awesome for getting behind the shoulder blades. Kind of those computer spots that we wind up holding a lot of tension. And it's a little bit of a forward fold. So again, you be the judge of how long you want to hang out there. So we will have our head below our heart. So take your left hand a little closer to center, right under your face, sweeping right arm up. So initially feeling this spin. And then taking this right arm through, we are going to thread this needle through the space between our hand and our knee, being right shoulder to the earth, right side of the head to the earth. Pausing here. You can walk the left fingertips all the way out to the front of the mat. It's like a half puppy stretch. Feel the length of the arms moving in this L kind of shape. And how that opens the space between the shoulders. Breathe in here. Just a modest version of our threading the needle pose today. And then slowly bring the left hand back on the mat near your nose. Press into that left hand and unthread. Aww. And pause and table for a moment to notice difference between left and right. Let's swish hips from side to side. Again, no right or wrong here. Swish of the lower body. Maybe it becomes a little side bend. Good, and then coming back to center and we'll get set up for threading the needle on the other side. So right hand a little closer to center, just right under your face. Left arm reaches up to the sky, but it's not just about this arm. We're really turning the belly, the ribs, the chest. Let the arm be more neutral. Yes. And now thread it through. Taking left shoulder down, left side of head to the earth, tail is in the air. Walk right fingers all the way forward. Breathing between the shoulder blades. Feel this L of the arms extending in their polar directions here, longitude and latitude. Good. And then bringing the right hand back on the mat by your nose. Press into it to uncurl. To table. Close your eyes now. Undulate. Whatever this feels like for you. Notice the spaces you've created. The belly, the ribs, the spine. What if you were in water? And this was just organic. Don't even have to think about it too much. Just let the body do what it loves. Breathing. Mindful movement, or maybe even stillness. Nice. When you are ready now, coming off these hands and knees and turning to sit. Bring soles of the feet together, round angle pose. And like what we did on the chair when we were rocking these hips, we've already done some hip opening and groin opening. And I know in gym class at some point we all did this as butterfly, but in yoga we actually don't bounce. We just let gravity assist us. And this is also a good place for blocks. If you've got any knee or hip things going on or simply want support here, prop the outer legs or knees with blocks. It just takes a little bit of the strain off so that you can relax into this more. So holding onto ankles, we're gonna press down through sits bones, up through crown. Exhale, hang backward, cat back, tucking the chin, rounding the mid back backwards, pulling the belly button in. Yes, and then pressing down through sits bones, let the belly move forward, heart raises, head raises, shoulders back. And then go the other way. So breathing this way a few times, back and forth. Your inhale is your lengthening and expanding. Exhale is contracting, going inward. Good. Next time that you're up and you're lengthened, let's breathe as we need to. Now we're going to let elbows come out towards knees and hinge forward. First, just flat back. Again, it might just be an inch or two. Be really cognizant of sensation, whether for low back or groin or hips. And being kind, nowhere to get to. Just curious. Just big inhale. Exhale, now round, head towards feet. Doesn't have to get there, going that direction. Pausing. Really letting the back body open. You feel as if the spine could melt out towards the sides, down the ribs. Yeah, relaxing the shoulders, the elbows, the head. These kinds of poses are sometimes called yin yoga. The yin being the more passive to the yang, the more active. So not about doing, more about letting go. One more breath here. Good, and then slowly uncurl. Take your time. Let me pause here. Just notice the after effects of forward folding. Calming for the nervous system. Let's let our hands help fold up these knees like a book and stretch them out. And we're going to get ready for just our final cool down poses on the mat. So if you want to put socks back on or a layer back on, I know it tends, the body cools down quickly, even though we might have gotten warm there in the middle. So feel free to put a layer back on and also potentially have your blanket nearby, so you'll be ready for Shavasana. And if you've got a pillow or a bolster, something that you like to use for Shavasana, also have that nearby, so you'll just be ready to fold right in. So if you've got a yoga tie, bring that with you. If you don't, it could be a scarf, belt, or you can simply do this with your hands, but it's helpful to have it. So we're going to take our right foot up, lying flat on the back. Left knee can just be bent with the foot on the floor. And guide this heel in some little circles. And again, you can do it with your hand by holding behind the thigh if you don't have a tie. We're just guiding heel in circles, which is really creating corresponding circles in that right hip. And corresponding massage for the right lower back. Circle the other direction now, nice and easy. Easing out this hip and leg. Good. pause for a moment. And then we're going to switch. So we'll take the left foot in the tie, right foot just on the floor with a knee bent, good support, or just holding onto your leg. We're going to guide this left heel now. Big circles on the ceiling. Do you guys remember spirograph? This kid's kind of a drawing thing with these plastic rings that would make all these geometric shapes. I loved that when I was a kid. And so I think about that when I do this, like making designs on the ceiling. Maybe we can all imagine the design we're co-creating with our circles. And circle the other direction now. Left hip, left kidney. Oh, getting a little massage here. Good. And then pausing at the top. Taking both feet up into the thigh and spread them out wide now. Or again, you can support with your hands, a big V. I like to let my hands come down towards the ends of the thigh to really relax the shoulders and elbows. You can pull in the belly button just a little bit, but it's really the press of the feet and the pull of the hands that create the structure of this with the thigh there. A wide angled open book pose, in this case reclined. Good. And then releasing the thigh if you've had it, bending the knees in, hug them into the chest, nice and snug. Maybe a little rocking side to side, again, to just massage the body, the back, the weight of your own body. Mm-hmm. Keeping right knee in, extend left leg out along the floor, all the way down to the bottom of the mat. Pausing here for a moment. Nice big inhale, draw head towards right knee. A little crunch here for a moment, balancing on your middle back. And then returning with control, the upper back, the head lands, and feel the traction that this stretch helps to create for the back. More extension for lower back particularly. Good, and switching legs. I'm gonna draw left knee in, extend right leg out along the earth. This wind relieving series, good for our digestion, our elimination. Nice big inhale, drawing head towards knee, balancing for a moment. And then slowly returning. Could you make your spine longer as you return? Maybe tucking the chin just slightly as you come down. Leaving a natural curve in the neck, but head just a little further up. Feeling the traction here. So good. And finally, drawing both knees in. Let's draw the knees wider, really wider. And let's hold behind the thighs here so you can draw each knee towards a shoulder. Again, it doesn't have to get there. We're just going that direction. Really feel more of your back on the earth. Flex your feet as if you want to stand on the ceiling. Twinkle the toes up there. Keeping the knees wide, knees going towards the earth. And reach up for instep or big toes or ankles. And this is happy baby pose. Our final pose before Shavasana. So doing a little rocking here, just nurturing, massaging the back body. One final release for hips and groin and legs. And the advanced version is turning up the corners of your mouth to make it the happy baby. Uh-huh. Good. Imagining we could kiss our toes. And then releasing Sliding all the way out now. And I'm going to invite you to get super comfy for your final relaxation. So if you have any lower back issues, you might like to have a bolster or two blocks side by side under your knees, maybe with a blanket over. One way to make kind of a makeshift bolster. This can be effective for just taking a little pressure off the low back as we relax. I'm going to invite you to put back on a layer, to maybe to get under a blankie. If you've got an eye pillow and you want to use that, feel free. Notice also if your head tends to tip back, if you need just a little support under your neck and not a big pillow, you just want it to be in alignment with the spine. So getting settled in, finding your comfortable place now. And as you land, just wiggle the hips, the shoulders, maybe let the head do a little natural tip side to side, and then find the middle so that there's space here now. Space for rest. A nice big inhale, nice big exhale. Just letting the front half of the body release towards the back half of the body. And the back half of the body be really held and cradled by the earth. Full support. Could you allow the face to soften, tiny lines melting away, the brow becoming smooth, the eyes heavy in their sockets, the cheeks melting down towards the ears, and the tongue and teeth and lips loose. It might mean breathing just a little bit through the lips as well as the nose, whatever feels natural. And noticing the breath. Not even needing to change it. Just becoming the witness. Sensing the subtle coolness of the inhale and the warmth of the exhale. With each exhale, imagining and knowing that our body is releasing what it doesn't need consciously and unconsciously, every breath. Knowing the release with the exhale of what no longer serves you. Shifting focus to the inhale. Feel like the inhale could draw to you all that you are wanting, all that is nourishing, life-giving, radiant health, joy, creativity, connection, love, whatever it is. Let it come in with the inhale and imagine it going to every cell. And then taking a deep breath in, and a full sigh of breath out. And another deep breath in, let it be an audible sigh of breath out for you. Letting fingers and toes wiggle. Starting to come back to the extremities. Letting the wrists and ankles do a little twizzle or take a yawn, stretch, sigh in any way that would feel really fabulous right now. And eventually bending in your knees, rolling to one side. Maybe just hug yourself there, make a little pillow with your lower arm. And just notice the after effects of your yoga. This yoking, bringing union. The union we're talking about is not just left or right or outer, up or down, night and day. It's the physical and the divine. You here in physical form as a divine being. And when you're ready, pressing yourself back up to sit. A few breaths together to end. And let's bring one hand to belly, one hand to heart again. Maybe even keeping your eyes closed. A felt sense of yourself from the inside out. Have we made more space? Is there more room for life, more room for breath, more room for you? And imagining you could sit in a column of light from the highest point in the universe, right down into the crown of your head, illuminating your thoughts, your actions, your energy field. So that you can also be a guide and a beacon for others. Bringing hands to prayer palms in front of the heart, dropping chin towards the chest one last time. Adi Om, Shanti, 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 peace, peace, peace. Shalom and namaste. Thank you so much for coming out to play with me today. I hope that was helpful for you.